Hey YouTube, back with another beer review. And today we have another one from Het Uitje. But it comes in a box and it's called Good Feathers. Like your good fellas. But you know Het Uitje, always putting their own twists to it. El Patron, Dom Perignon, and we have El Chapeau. Yeah, you know, all these guys, but they give it different names. So this one is brewed for the 8 years anniversary of the brewery. So they exist already 8 years. So you know, Het Uitje is from the Netherlands in Haarlem. And they, like I told you before, they have their brewery there. They have a pub there and a bottle shop. So if you go to Haarlem, do check them out. This is nicely packed. So I'm guessing there will be a can in here. I like the box. I really like the box. Okay. Look at this. Nicely done. Really nice again. Like always, the graphics from Het Uitje are really amazing. So, it comes in at 8.5% ABV. And the malt base is rather special. They only used Pilsner malts and flaked rice. Flaked rice. That's a strange combination, of course, for the malts, and that's all that these are the only malts in here, guys. So the malt base is just Pilsner malt and your rice in here, flaked rice. Okay, so they are also 4 hops in here. So the Equinut, and then another one I haven't heard of yet. Anyway, Pato, it's called Talus. I also never heard of it, and your Sabre hop. Sabre hop does deliver some kind of like your coconut taste to it, but not that much, of course. Yeah, okay, 8 years of the brewery. I'm gonna see if I am correct about the ABV on it, because I just read it somewhere. Yeah, 8.5% ABV for 40 milliliter can. Okay, let's crack it open. So like I told you before, guys, this gets a higher rating. So I don't think many people know the style Brut IPA. So a Brut IPA is like a Brut Champagne, like it will be more dry. So this will be a really dry IPA, like your Champagne, the Brut style. It's the same for the IPAs. It is rather dry. But it looks really nice. Like your straw golden color to it. One finger heads. Quite some carbonation going on. I think you can see it. Okay. Let's get to the nose. Cheers, guys. Real hoppy. Really hoppy. And you get the dryness indeed. It's not like your, yeah, your other IPAs. You get the dryness also a little bit on the nose. And this one is gonna be, it's citrusy in the nose also. Like, yeah, I think this one is gonna be really fruity. Okay, let's try it, guys. Cheers. It is dry. It is really dry. So not your sweetness of your regular IPAs, whatever the style, West Coast IPA or a New England IPA. These ones, the Brut IPAs, are much, much drier. But you get that fruitiness indeed. Like, it's also citrusy. It's really peachy. Some grapefruit notes in here. That's really nice. It is malty, but you get a flaked rice rather well also in here. You can taste, it's not your regular malts, but the flake, the rice, the when you have your rice, you eat it, and then you have this typical rice feel, and this is also in here that might give a little bit to that dryness also, the rice. But yeah, it's otherwise it's just the Pilsner malt they used. So it is refreshing. It isn't sweet at all. It's dry as hell. And your fruity notes, really important. a slight bitterness at the end, but like it's floral. It's slight grassy, but more floral. Yeah, and I told you about the peach, the citrusy notes. There's a, yeah, the grapefruity notes are also in here. And it has a really light sourness to it, but really, really light sourness. But that's more the yeast they use, because they mostly use, to make this also dry, the brut IPAs, they mostly use champagne yeast, what is a common thing, of course. But it's really in balance. It's really full flavored. So for the style, am I a fan of this? Well, you know, I like IPAs, but the brut style is the least one I prefer to have. But this one is really well done, and it comes in an awesome package also. So, you know, there is some work. They made some work to it to brew this one. No, I'm going to rate this like, let's say, 7.5 out of 10. For me, this is a 7.5 out of 10. So if you can find it, it is a little bit more expensive than the other cans from het Uiltje. But like here in Belgium and in the Netherlands, it will be really cheap. So if you do visit Haarlem one day, or another city that's really close to Haarlem, do visit these guys, or at least the bottle shop or the pub when they're open again. You won't be disappointed by these beers from het Uiltje. I did some more reviews about them, and I think they have a really nice range of beers if it comes to the beers of Netherlands, of course. So, okay. That was all, guys. I'm going to round it up. So, don't forget, a beer day keeps Dr. Ray. Till tomorrow. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe, please, if you want. Thank you. Bye. Cheers.